This is a four-place centrifuge. It's electric. I started out with a hand crank. I'm getting too old for that. And you have to, when you put them in, you have to put them in intelligently and so they're balanced. Otherwise, you start rocking the boat. And that's kind of why it's on a little bit of a table with some tie-down on its own table. Otherwise, this baby gets rocking. So we'll see in a little bit. And as the trays come, you put them in and then you do one side. And then after it's all centrifuged out, you bring them up and flip them over so you can do the other side. So it works pretty slick. So
cool.
Everything's stainless steel.
So stainless steel. Nice.
What are you saying? Well, if you are too flat, then you're digging in.
Okay.
So you want to lay it flat up against the...
So you don't, or you do want to lay it flat?
Well,
this is like a little shaver. It's a new kind.
Okay,
wow, look at that.
Like you're shaving it off, right?
Yeah.
Am I leaving too much?
No, you're doing great.
Okay.
Just like that.
So sticky, huh?
Uh-huh. Well, you'll get some honey to taste without the wax today.
And then what do you do with the wax? Can you make candles out of it?
Yeah, we've got a few hanging around. I wanted to make... experiment a bit and do some lip balm and some lotions. And
you put wax and lotions?
Different creams, you know, lip balms and all sorts of.
Birch bees.
You're not having to dig into it. You want,
furniture
you want
polish.
The,
yeah.
You want the bees to be able to reuse the wax. They'll just reuse it. They'll make it all pretty again. But the less you disturb the wax, the cells.
Have you seen these new ones?
Are they awesome?
Just shiny.
I almost think they go, like you said, lay it flat.
Yeah. It just seems to go in a little bit deep if you lay it completely flat. So
So if you have to, go sideways.
Okay. Okay, I'm getting too much honey here. And then you turn it over and do the other side?
Yeah.
Isn't all the honey
going to
run out?
Yeah, that's why you keep it up on end, on the
tray.
Getting the best you can.
Oh, so it stays within the cells there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's a sticky business, huh?
Yeah.
All right, let's see what's going to happen here.
Is this your first year, then?
Me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
I know.
Look at that.
I read someplace that when they opened the tombs in Egypt that there was honey and it was still good.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Moisture can get
to
it.
And that you're supposed to put it on cuts and stuff? Like that? You ever heard that?
Yeah.
You can. Cuttings, you can dip the stems of plants in it before, and then before you try to root them, it'll kill any
bacteria.
Oh.
Yeah, just keep it to the right.
You smear honey on a plant's root, and then
you just dip the plant. You know, if you've made a cutting
yeah.
that you want to root, then you know before you actually put it in the soil, just dip it. Or put it in water or in the soil. You just dip it in some honey.
We're gonna get these ones.
It's got antibacterial properties in it.
Mm.
And it's supposed to help with allergies.
It's help with what?
Allergies.
Oh.
Local honey, right?
Local indigenous.
Indigenous honey.
You can ask, you can suck on the wax.
Well, we gave some for Lee. She'd never tried it before. We gave her some of the wax to chew. She was like,
It was oddly good.
Any more?
Yeah.
And the little bits that we get on the trays, we get back to the bees.
Yeah.
And they will be back at the full again, and we'll take it back.
So we save a little bit for the bees over there.
Oh, yes, we do. All the summer. We always have to give back. So like titles.
That's awesome. So it does, how many of these? Four at a time?
Four. Yeah, we're going to do four at a time. If we, it's a little more organized if I just decap four and then take them back out, because we don't want a lot of bee traffic in here. Once
yeah.
they start cooking here, they're gonna the bees will smell the honey.
Oh, really?
Oh, boy.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's why it's not advised to do this kind of thing outside.
Yeah.
I did that one year with an old hand crank, and they were everywhere.
Oh, wow.
Give me our honey back.
Uh-oh. And this again is called what?
A centrifuge.
Centrifuge.
You know, like a nuclear reactor.
Yeah. Except for spinning up bee juice.
We are spinning.
Move.
Like there's no tomorrow.
Move.
Contamination, cross-contamination. Like if you decide to have some honey on your toast and you whack some butter on the toast first and take that same knife with the butter on and dip it into the honey, you'll possibly crystallize the honey then.
Huh. Look how that's so shiny.
Yeah. I got kind of a steady hand because I do lots of needlework.
Oh, that looks great. Look at that.
Yeah. See, I did the worst job because look how much honey I've got in mine. Look how much Naomi has. Look.
Yeah. But you used a different tool, right?
It's called transition, Linda. You're learning. This is good.
And you used a different tool, you said, right?
Well, I use this. Well, I don't know. I've never used any tool.
Get it started and then you can look down here in a moment.
Spinning up. So as it's spinning around and around and around, that honey is just flying up against the walls of that.
You can take a look.
Okay,
can you see it spitting out for yourself?
Maybe some on the side there, yeah. Whoa, can't keep up now. That's so neat. Yeah, it can't. Having a hard time.
She's back!
Yay! They were closed.
Really? So we'll show you what it looks like.
Oh, I was going to get my light so it will light up the inside.
Yeah.
This is probably what they did 100 years ago even, right?
They cranked it by hand.
Need this light.
They just took the whole hive and squeezed.
How are you doing, Steve Reno?
No,
so this is what it looks like when it's empty.
All empty.
Oh, just the fork.
Cool.
Wow.
And we'll flip them.
Oops, uh-oh.
There.
All right, we seem to be having some issues. What's going on here, Terry?
Well, right now the honey has come up to the bottom of the basket, so the basket won't spin.
Uh-oh.
So we have to relieve the centrifuge of some of the honey.
So now you get to see that.
We're going to put it into a filtering bucket. Do you want to do the honors? You want to crack the business? You got to unscrew the white thing a little bit. Other way. Lefty loosey, righty tighty. And then flip the black one up a little bit.
That's good. Now lift that.
Wow.
Now we're talking.
Oh my, look at that.
Oh, so that's where you're trying to get the rest of that wax out?
Yeah, yeah, there's too much honey on the bottom, so it can't spin.
Oh, okay.
Now this is filtering it. There's how many layers of filtration?
Well, there's...
There's one and then three.
Three?
Yeah, there's like 1,500, 2,000 micro. So you don't get any wings, legs, or eyeballs.
Oh.
Pretty sweet.
I'd be careful. Does that dog ever go over there and...
Lap it up?
Pulga? I don't know what Pulga's going to do. It's her first time here. Seeing this.
It's the first time Honey gets the honey? Really going now, isn't it?
That's good.
Jeez Louise.
Yeah, there's a lot of times I know that look a lot like my second cousin.
Log down.
Yeah,
more than my first cousin. More room.
Good shot is when we're doing pouring the jars of honey. You can stick that camera right inside. You can watch the honey filter through.
Oh wow!
Little fingers.
Oh wow! Okay.
Good color for this early in the season.
Mm-hmm. Does the color change throughout the season?
It's a little darker towards the end.
And what causes the darkness?
Trees.
The trees going through change.
Yeah, a lot of times, towards the end of the season, so I've read, the bees will go after a little bit of tree sap that summer, and that'll change, make it a little darker. Plus, towards the end of the summer too, if it's really warm, the plants will drop more nutrients and business from the root system, which will change the color. This much in here, inch. This will come down. We'll end up with about that much there. So
okay.
Let's sit here for a little while.
So you're just separating the pieces and parts.
Well, all we're doing is making it more viscous. It's thinner. As it warms up, it's thinner. It'll get through the filter quicker.
Ah, okay. So there's a filter inside there.
Well, there's three filters here. I'll show you upstairs.
Okay.
There's three different grades of filters.
Okay, cool.
Let's go look.
So it's real warm in there, and that's why
Oh, boy.
All right, so this is the filters that Terry was talking about earlier. There's a different, level
mesh?
Of... Yeah, level of meshness to them. So it'll get filtered three separate times. One, and then a thinner filter, and then even a finer one. So it's triple filtered.
Really nice too.
Does it?
Yeah.
Does it smell like honey?
It just smells like honeycombs, and I like that smell. It's,
yeah.
It's, you know.
I like the honeycomb cereal too.
Yeah.
That definitely has sugar in it.
Well, you like what do you call it? Beeswax.
I hope you like
candles. They smell so good.
Thank you.
They do actually smell really good.
Yeah.
I used to make them all the time.
It's that stiff. Yeah.
I don't like that.
Man, she's been a trooper the whole time.
Bottles of water in the fridge if anyone wants any.
She's got 6 years experience.
Oh, does she? She's been doing this a while, huh?
And I got bottles of beer in the bottom of the fridge if anybody wants one.
You're not driving.
Nope, I'm not. I got a small glass of wine over here.
They're on the last bit of trays here that are going to come from out there into the centrifuge.